You have been in suspension for 50 days. In compliance with state and federal regulations, all testing candidates in the Aperture Science Extended Relaxation Center must be revived periodically for a mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise.
With good mental.
You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look up at the ceiling. Good. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look down at the floor. Good. This completes the gymnastic portion of your mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. There is a framed painting on the wall. Please go stand in front of it. This is art. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, stare at the art. You should now feel mentally reinvigorated. If you suspect staring at art has not provided the required intellectual sustenance, reflect briefly on this classical music. Good. Now please return to your bed. Good morning. You have been in suspension for 9999999.
Hello? Anyone in there? Oh, God. You look good. Looking good, actually. Are you okay? Are you... Don't answer that. I'm absolutely sure you're fine. There's plenty of time for you to recover. Just take...
Please prepare for emergency evacuation.
Stay calm. Stay calm. Prepare. That's all we're saying. Prepare. It's all fine. All right. Don't move. I'm going to get us out of here. Oh, you might want to hang on to something. Word of advice. Up to you. Most test subjects do experience some cognitive deterioration after a few months in suspension. Now, you've been under for quite a lot longer, and it's not out of the question that you might have a very minor case of serious brain damage. But don't be alarmed, all right? Although, if you do, if you do feel
silly
alarmed,
to me.
Try to hold on to
this
that,
whole part
because
is
that is the proper reaction
stupid.
To being told that you've got brain damage.
Like, so
do
much
you understand
of it
what
just,
I'm saying
like, watching
at all? Does any of this make any sense? Just tell me, just say yes. Okay, what you're doing there is jumping. You just jumped. But never mind. Say apple. Apple. Okay, you know what? That's close enough. Just hold tight.
All reactor core safeguards are now non-functional. Please prepare for reactor core meltdown.
Okay, look, I wasn't going to mention this to you, but I'm in pretty hot water here. How are you doing down there? You still holding on? The reserve power ran out. So, of course, the whole relaxation center stops waking up the bloody test subjects. Hold on, this is a bit tricky. And, of course, nobody tells me anything. No, why should you tell me anything? Why should I be careful for? You know, about the life functions of the 10,000 bloody test subjects I'm supposed to be in charge of. Right, close. Can you see? Am I going to make it through? I've got enough space. Just gotta get through here.
My pre-John for this one.
And whose fault do you think it's gonna be when the management comes down here? And
I'm actually playing the
map
without a mouse. Like, I'm actually using a touchpad.
Okay, listen, we should get our story straight, alright? If anyone asks, and no one's gonna ask,
and
don't
I have
worry,
a.
If
the portal
tell
buttons
them as far as you know,
Q and
the last
E.
Time you checked, everyone looked pretty much alive. Alright, not dead. Okay, almost there. On the other side of that wall is one of the old testing tracks. There's a piece of equipment in there that we're going to need to get out of here.
We're going
I think this is a docking
that,
station.
Whatever.
Get ready. Good news. That is not a docking station. So there's one mystery solved. I'm going to attempt a manual override on this wall. Could get a bit technical. Hold on. Almost there. Remember, you're looking for a gun that makes holes. Not bullet holes. But don't worry, you'll figure it out. Seriously, do hold on this time.
Come on.
Hello, and again welcome to the Aperture Science Enrichment Center. We are currently experiencing technical difficulties due to circumstances of potentially apocalyptic significance beyond our control. However, thanks to emergency testing protocols, testing can continue. These pre-recorded messages will provide instructional and motivational support so that science can still be done, even in the event of environmental, social, economic, or structural collapse. The portal will open, and emergency testing will begin in 3, 2, 1. Cube and button-based testing remains an important tool for science, even in a dire emergency. If cube and button-based testing caused this emergency, don't worry. The odds of this happening twice are very slim. If you feel liquid running down your neck, relax, lie on your back, and apply immediate pressure to your temples. You are simply experiencing a rare reaction in which the material emancipation grill may have emancipated the ear tubes inside your head. Good. Because of the technical difficulties we are currently experiencing, your test environment is unsupervised. Before re-entering a relaxation vault at the conclusion of testing, please take a moment to write down the results of your test. An Aperture Science Reintegration Associate will revive you for an interview when society has been rebuilt. If the Earth is currently governed by a manner of animal king, sentient cloud, or other governing body that either refuses to or is incapable of listening to us.
Hey, you made it! There should be a portal! Oh. Also, are you alive? That's important. Should have asked that first. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to work on the assumption that you're still alive. And I'm just going to wait for you up ahead.
Always 1 hour, then I'll come back. And assuming I can locate your dead body.
Some emergency testing may require prolonged interaction with lethal military androids. Rest assured that all lethal military androids have been taught to read and provided with one copy of the Laws of Robotics. To share. Good. If you feel that a lethal military android has not respected your rights as detailed in the Laws of Robotics, please note it on your self-reporting form. A future Aperture Science Entitlement Associate will initiate the appropriate grievance filing paperwork. This next test is very dangerous. To help you remain tranquil in the face of almost certain death, Smooth Janice will be deployed in 3, 2, 1.
Go.
Great work. Because this message is pre-recorded, any observations related to your performance are speculation on our part. Please disregard any undeserved compliments.
Wow. That was quite bad.
If the enrichment center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space, please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test.
Can you stay on the button?
Thank you. Well done. The Enrichment Center reminds you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts. This next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through portals. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you. If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future. And the future starts with you. Good work getting this far, future starter. That said, if you are simple-minded, old, or irradiated in such a way that the future should not start with you, please return to your primitive tribe and send back someone better qualified for testing.
Irradiated in such a way.
To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The Enrichment Center respects your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
Hey! Hi! I'm up here! Oh, brilliant! You did find a portal gun! Do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Okay, listen, let me lay something on you here. It's pretty heavy. They told me never, never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail or I would die. But we're out of options here, so get ready to catch me. All right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready? One. Two. Three!
I know
that's
this
high.
Is
it's too high, isn't it, really, that?
Like...
All right, going on three just gives you too much time. Think about it. Let's go on one this time. Okay, ready? One. Catch me! Ow!
That was actually a waste of time.
I'm not dead! Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll
actually
show you
just
something.
Wasted like
you'll
three
be
seconds.
Impressed by this. Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching. Seriously, I'm not joking. Can you just turn around for a second? Alright, you can turn around now. Secret panel. Fly open while your back was turned, and off we go. Look at this! No rail to tell us where to go! Oh, this is brilliant. We go wherever we want. Hold on though, where are we going? Seriously. Hang on, let me just get my bearings. Just follow the rail, actually. Oh no. Yes, hello, we're not stopping. Don't make eye contact, whatever you do. No, thanks, we're good. Appreciate it. Keep moving. Probably ought to bring you up to speed on something right now. In order to escape, we're going to have to go through her chamber, and she will probably kill us if she's awake. Okay, I'm going to lay my cards on the table. I don't want to do it. I don't want to go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. Don't panic over it. She's off. All fine. All we'll go. There she is. What a nasty piece of work she was, honestly. Like a proper maniac. Do you know who ended up purging her, taking her down here? You're not going to believe this. A human. I know, I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him. Ah! Oh, still held! Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the grit, we're all fine. I just looked down. I do not recommend it. Done it again. This is the main breaker room. Look for a switch that says escape pod. Alright, don't touch anything else. Not interested in anything else. Don't touch anything else. Don't even look at anything else. Obviously you've got to look at everything else to find the escape pod. But as soon as you look at something, it doesn't say escape pod. Look at something else. Look at the next thing, all right? But don't touch anything else or look at anything. Well, look at other things, but don't. You understand. Can you see it anywhere? can't see it anyway. Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on. Let there be light. That's God. It's quoting God. Oh, look at that. Turning. Ominous. But probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, you know, moving up. Now, escape pod. It's moving up.
Okay. No, don't worry. I've got it. This should slow it down.
No, makes it go faster.
Uh-oh.
Power up initiated.
Okay, don't panic. All right, stop panicking. I can still stop this. There's a pass. Okay, it's fine.
How have you been? I've been really busy. After you murdered me.
You did what? No!
Okay, look, we both said a lot of things that you're going to regret. But I feel we can put our differences behind us. For science, you monster. I will say, though, that since you went to all the trouble of waking me up, you must really, really love to taste. I love it, too. There's just one small thing we need to take care of first. Trip over any parts of you. You didn't get completely burnt when you threw them down here. The dual portal device should be around here somewhere. Once you find it, we can start testing, just like there it is. There. Good. You have the dual portal device. There should be a way back to the testing area up ahead. Once testing starts, I'm required by protocol to keep interaction with you to a minimum. Luckily, we haven't started testing. This will be our only chance to talk. Do you know the biggest lesson I learned from what you did? I discovered I have a sort of black box quicksave feature. In the event of a catastrophic failure, the last 2 minutes of my life are preserved for analysis. I was able, well, forced really, to relive you killing me again and again, forever. Do you know, if you'd done that to somebody else, they might devote their existence to exacting revenge. Luckily, I'm a bigger person than that. I'm happy to put this all behind us and get back to work. After all, we've got a lot to do, and only 60 more years to do it. More or less. I don't have the actuarial tables in front of me. But the important thing is you're back. With me. And now I'm on to all your little tricks. So there's nothing to stop us from testing for the rest of your life. After that, who knows? I might take up a hobby. Reanimating the dead, maybe. Sorry about the mess. I've really let the place go since you killed me. By the way, thanks for that.
Sarcasm self-test complete.
Oh good, that's back online. I'll start getting everything else working while you perform this first simple test, which involves deadly lasers and how test subjects react when locked in a room with deadly lasers. Not bad. I forgot how good you are at this. You should pace yourself, though. We have a lot of tests to do.
I haven't missed that portal in a while.
Okay,
This next test involves discouragement redirection cues. I just finished building them before you had your, well, episode. So now we'll both get to see how they work. There should be one in the corner. Well done. Here come the test results. You are a horrible person. That's what it says. A horrible person. We weren't even testing for that. Don't let that horrible person thing discourage you. It's just a data point. If it makes you feel any better, science has now validated your birth mother's decision to abandon you on a doorstep.
What?
Congratulations, not on the test. Most people emerge from suspension terribly undernourished. I want to congratulate you on beating the odds and somehow managing to pack on a few pounds. One moment. You are navigating these test chambers faster than I can build them, so feel free to slow down. Do whatever it is you do when you're not destroying this facility. I'll give you credit. I guess you are listening to me. And for the record, you don't have to go that slowly. This next test involves the Aperture Science Aerial Faceplate. It was part of an initiative to investigate how well test subjects could solve problems when they were catapulted into space. Results were highly informative. They could not. Good luck. Here's an interesting fact. You're not breathing real air. It's too expensive to pump this far down. We just take carbon dioxide out of a room, freshen it up a little, and pump it back in, so you'll be breathing the same room full of air for the rest of your life. I thought that was interesting. Let's see what the next test is. Oh, advanced aerial faceplates. Well, have fun soaring through the air without a care in the world. I have to go to the wing that was made entirely of glass and pick up 15 acres of broken glass by myself. Oh, sorry. I'm still cleaning out the test chambers, so sometimes there's still trash in there. Standing around, smelling and being useless. Try to avoid the garbage hurtling towards you. Remember before when I was talking about smelly garbage standing around being useless? That was a metaphor. I was actually talking about you. And I'm sorry. You didn't react at the time, so I was worried it sailed right over your head, which would have made this apology seem insane. That's why I had to call you garbage a second time just now.
Too much, girls. Too much.
Did you know that people with guilty consciences are more easily startled by loud noises? I'm sorry, I don't know why that went off. Anyway, Justin, oh, did I accidentally fizzle that before you could complete the test? I'm sorry. Go ahead and grab another one. Oh, no. I fizzled that one too. Oh well. We have warehouses full of the things. Absolutely worthless. I'm happy to get rid of them.
Game works very hard to make you angry.
Every test chamber is equipped with an emancipation grill at its exit, so that test subjects cannot smuggle test objects out of the test area. This one is broken. Don't take anything with you. I think that one was about to say, I love you. They are sentient, of course. We just have a lot of them. This next test involves emancipation grills. Remember, I told you about them in the last test area that did not have one.
Make a portal! Hey, well, that was...
The termites again. I have to go. Wait, this next test does require some explanation. Let me give you the fast version. There. If you have any questions, just remember what I said in slow motion. Test on your own recognizance.
That was terrible.
Must not be calibrated to someone of your generousness. I'll add a few zeros to the maximum weight. You look great, by the way. Very healthy. Right now.
Right, complete eye.
You seem to have defeated its load-bearing capacity. Well done. I'll just lower the ceiling.
There we go. Cool.
Sailing through the air majestically, like an eagle, piloting a blimp.
Nothing majorly terrible has happened with this one.
Enjoy this next test. I'm going to go to the surface. It's a beautiful day out. Yesterday I saw a deer. If you solve this next test, maybe I'll let you ride an elevator all the way up to the break room. And I'll tell you about the time I saw a deer again.
When she tells you about the time I saw a deer. Oh boy. Yo, if I can get this keeper.
I didn't see the deer today. I did see some humans, but with you here, I've got more test subjects than I'll ever need.
I was way too late on that.
Bridges are made from natural light that I pump in from the surface. If you rubbed your cheek on one, it would be like standing outside with the sun shining on your face. It would also set your hair on fire, so don't actually do it.
Okay, that's close.
Excellent. You're a predator, and these tests are your prey. Speaking of which, I was researching sharks for an upcoming test. Do you know who else murders people who are only trying to help them? Did you guess sharks? Because that's wrong. The correct answer is nobody. Nobody but you is that pointlessly cruel.
Well, that saved, like, probably 15-ish seconds from my last run. My last run of that chamber was exceedingly terrible.
Good news. I figured out what to do with all the money I saved recycling your one room full of air. When you die, I'm going to laminate your skeleton and pose you in the lobby. That way future generations can learn from you how not to have your unfortunate bone structure. Perfect. The door's malfunctioning. I guess somebody's going to have to repair that too. No, don't get up. I'll be right back. Don't touch anything.
Hey, Mike! Up here! I found some bird eggs up there.
I skipped this cutscene one time and I don't know how I did it.
Bird!
I just walked and I just went through the door.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't know how I did that.
Livid! Okay, look, the point is, we're gonna break out of here, alright? Very soon, I promise. I just have to figure out how to break us out of here.
Here
she comes.
Keep
testing. Just keep testing.
So good.
Remember, you never saw me. Never saw me.
I went and spoke with the door mainframe. Let's just say he won't be. Well,
I don't know why I thought backing into this would be
good. Anyway, back to testing.
Oh, shit. Too low.
I went and spoke with the door mainframe. Let's just say he won't be, well, living anymore. Anyway, back to testing.
Okay.
Well done. In fact, you did so well. I'm going to note this on your file. I didn't in do the that. Commendation section.
That was actually
there's lots of room here.
One of the worst runs of that chamber I've ever had.
Enough.
That was like a minute. That was like a minute time loss.
This next test involves turrets. You remember them, right? They're the pale spherical things that are full of bullets. Oh wait, that's you in 5 seconds. Good luck.
Oh my god. It didn't pick up the cube!
To maintain a constant testing cycle, I simulate daylight at all hours and add adrenal vapor to your oxygen supply.
Oh, probably not.
So you may be confused about the passage of time. The point is, yesterday was your birthday. I thought you'd want to know. You know how I'm going to live forever, but you're going to be dead in 60 years? Well, I've been working on a belated birthday present for you. Well, more of a belated birthday medical procedure. Well, technically, it's a medical experiment. What's important is it's a present.
That's the important part. It's all that really matters. Yeah.
That jumpsuit you're wearing looks stupid. That's not me talking. It's right here in your file. On other people it looks fine. But right here a scientist has noted that on you it looks stupid. Well, what does a neckbeard, an old engineer, know about fashion? He probably... Oh, wait, it's a she. Still, what does she know? Oh, wait, it says she has a medical degree. In fashion, from France. I'm going through the list of test subjects in cryogenic storage. I managed to find two with your last name. A man and a woman. So that's interesting. It's a small world. I have a surprise waiting for you after this next test. Telling you would spoil the surprise. So I'll just give you a hint. It involves meeting two people you haven't seen in a long time. Hello. It says this next test was designed by one of Aperture's Nobel Prize winners. It doesn't say what the prize was for. Well, I know it wasn't for being immune to neurotoxin. I bet you think I forgot about your surprise. I didn't. In fact, we're headed to your surprise right now. After all these years, I'm getting choked up just thinking about it.
I know, are there 2.5 minutes of loads in the first 2 chapters?
Initiating surprise in 3, 2, 1. I made it all up. Surprise. Oh, come on. If it makes you feel any better, they abandoned you at birth. So I very seriously doubt that even one
Top 10 reactions.
I
knew that was going to happen.
Feel awful about that surprise. Tell you what, let's give your parents a call right now.
The birth parents who are trying to reach do not love you. Please hang up.
Oh, that's nice. But impressive. Maybe they worked at the phone company.
It's
definitely a lot faster.
I talked my way onto the old nanobot work.
Definitely a lot faster.
They are crazy. I know, Jerry. No,
oh, yeah, I didn't die.
Just hang in there for 5 more. What, Jerry? You can't fire me for that. Yes, Jerry. Or maybe your prejudiced work site should have accommodated a nanobot of my size. Thanks for the hate crime, Jer. See you in court, mate. Anyway, look, just hang in there for 5 more chambers.
Chapter 4 is so short. I say it every time I read this.
Well, you know the old formula.
It just strikes
me. Comedy equals tragedy plus time.
How short this chapter is.
And you have been asleep for a while, so I guess it's actually pretty funny when you do the math.
Yo, we got it. Okay. Ah, fuck it. What? I'm so shitty. There. kidding me? I get the glitch. Give me that. Yes.
I thought about our dilemma, and I came up with a solution that I honestly think works out best for one of both of us.
That was still probably faster than the previous one. The previous one was pretty bad.
Federal regulations require me to warn you that this next test chamber is looking pretty good. That's right. The facility is completely operational again. I think these test chambers look even better than they did before. It was easy, really. You just have to look at things objectively, see what you don't need anymore, and trim out the fat.
That hurt, Gladys. That hurt deep.
I've got a surprise for you after this next test. Not a fake, tragic surprise like last time. A real surprise with tragic consequences. And real confetti this time. The good stuff. Our last bell. What's going on? Who turned off the lights?
Hey, buddy, I'm speaking in an accent that is beyond her range of hearing.
Look, metal ball, I can hear you.
Bud, I need to do the voice. Bud!
What?
Bud! Bud! Come on, let's close the door. Okay, quick recap. We are escaping. All right, that's what's happening now. We're escaping. So you're doing great. Just keep running. Quit worrying about the future plans that I've got in store. We're going to shut down the entire production line, all right? Turn off her neurotoxin.
The irony is, you were almost at the last test. Here it is. Why don't you just do it? Trust me, it's an easier way out than whatever asinine plan your friend came up with.
A what? How stupid does she think we are? Don't! Run, for goodness sake!
Well done. Okay, follow me. We've still got work to do. What's that? Okay. Don't move. Okay. All right. So, I've got an idea, but it is bloody dangerous. Here we go. Ah! Oh, for God's sake. They told me that if I ever turned this flashlight on, I would die. They told me that about everything. I mean, I don't even know why they bothered giving me this. Ooh. Dark down here, isn't it? They say that the old caretaker of this place went absolutely crazy. chopped up his entire staff of robots. More than robots, they say at night you can still hear the screams of their replicas, all of them functionally indistinguishable from the originals. No memory of the incident, nobody knows what they're talking about. Absolutely terrifying. Though obviously not quite a normal, painful way. Quick, this way. Here's an interesting story, you might like this. I almost got a job down here in manufacturing, but guess who the foreman was? Only an exact duplicate of himself. Ended up giving me the worst possible job, tending to all the smelly humans that just tending to the humans. Sorry about that, I'm being sensitive. The smelly humans. I tell you.
I thought there was a fence.
Oh, love them. Just the way they look. It's great. And their folklore. Wonderful. And colourful. Right. Well, I'm going to take this rail down the back one. See you, Paul.
All right. Didn't die there. Having a pretty good chapter 5 so far. Still lots of stuff to do, but...
Turret redemption lines active. Please do not engage with turrets heading towards redemption. Turret redemption lines are not rides. Please exit the turret redemption line.
Control center, thank you very much. See that scanner right there? It's deciding which turrets to keep and which to toss, and it's using that master turret there as a template. Now, if we pull out the template turret, it'll shut down the whole
response.
Right, I'm gonna have to hack the door so that we can get at it. Technical, you'll need to turn around while I do this. Done! Hack! Okay, go on, just pull that turret out. Well, that should do it.
Template, listen. Continuing from memory.
Oh, that's good. What do you have there? What
template?
Oh, brilliant! That's brilliant!
New template accepted.
If we're lucky, she won't find out what her turrets have happened until it's too late. Classic. Okay, keep your eye on the turret line. I'm going to go and hack the door open. Was there any sort of announcement before opening, like a buzzer or an alarm of some kind, or like a hacker alert? I mean, you know, fair enough, the important thing is it's open, but just mention. Alright, now, she can't use her turrets, so let's go and take care of that neurotop. Bring your daughter to work day. That did not end well. And 40 potato batteries. Embarrassing. I mean, I realise they're children, but still, you know, low-hanging fruit or barely science, really. I'm pretty sure we're going the right way, just to reassure you. Don't worry, I'm absolutely guaranteeing you 100% it's this way. No, it's not this way. Okay, let's try this one.
Apparently he's very good chat with that.
I knew we were going the right way! This is the neurotoxin generator. Bit bigger than I expected. I'm not going to be able to just, you know, push it over. Have to apply some cleverness. There's some sort of control room up at the top, so let's go and investigate. I can use this equipment to shut down the neurotoxin system. It is, however, password protected. Ah, alarm bells.
You saw neurotoxin? Oh, neurotoxin levels are going down. Hold on, Johnny.
Neurotoxin levels up to 50%.
Sorry, Jack. Sorry,
I'm going to say that. Neurotoxin at
0%.
Yes. Hold on.
Warning. Neurotoxin pressure has reached dangerously unlethal levels.
This should take us right to her. I can't believe I'm finally doing this. I knew this would be fun. They told me it wasn't fun at all, so they said not fun at all. I believed them. I don't have to fool to myself. Oh, and I'm loving this. Way over time. This place is huge. I'm really seeing the top layer. It goes down for miles. All sealed off years ago, of course. We should be getting close. Oh, I can't wait to see the look on her face. No neurotoxin, no turret. She'll never know what hit her. Hold on, because I might not have thought this next part could be. Ah! What? I'm going the wrong way! Get to her! I'll find you!
Honestly, truly didn't think you'd fall for that. In fact, I devised a much more elaborate trap further ahead for when you got through this easy one. If I'd known you let yourself get captured this easily, I would have just dangled a turkey leg on a rope from the ceiling. Well, it was nice catching up. Let's get to business. I hope you brought something stronger than a portal gun this time. Otherwise, I'm afraid you're about to become the immediate past president of the Being Alive Club. Uh-huh. Seriously, though. Goodbye.
It's my big chance. This is
Oh, you were busy back there. Well, I suppose we could just sit in this room and glare at each other until somebody drops dead. But I have a better idea. It's your old friend, Deadly Neurotoxin. If I were you, I'd take a deep breath and hold it.
Hello!
I hate you so much.
Warning, central core is 80% corrupt.
That's fine. I don't feel corrupt. In fact, I feel pretty good.
Alternate core detected.
Oh, that's me they're talking about!
To initiate a core transfer, please deposit substitute core in receptacle.
Torture.
Substitute core accepted. Substitute core, are you ready to start the procedure?
Yes.
Corrupted core, are you ready to start the procedure?
No.
Oh, yes, she is.
No.
Stalemate detected. Transfer procedure cannot continue.
Yes.
Unless a stalemate associate is present to press the stalemate resolution button.
Leave me in!
Don't press it!
Not so fast. Think about this. You need to be a trained stalemate associate to press that button.
Stalemate resolved.
this hurts? What if this really hurts? Oh, I didn't think of that.
Oh, it will. Believe me, it will.
Are you just saying that, or is it really going to hurt? You're just saying that, aren't you? You're just... No, you're not. You're like, it is going to hurt, isn't it? Exactly how painful are we
No. Stop. No. 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 No.
Gladys conveys more emotion in that scene than she does in like the entire rest of the series. And she's a little potato. It's incredible. Really, really great. Alright. Well, nothing I can do to go past you, so. What the hell? I never noticed that. I never noticed that the lift fell too. I've actually never used.
If you could unstrap one of those long fall boots of yours and shove me into it, just remember to land on one foot.
It's so funny. I seriously never noticed that the elevator was just falling above me. I've played this game through, like, I've played this game dozens of times. I've never noticed that. That's crazy. Oh, and it's just dangling there. Not once. Oh, come on. First flip is it? First flip is it?
Astronauts, war heroes, Olympians, you're here because we want the best. And you are it. Now, who is ready to make some science?
I am.
Now, you already met one another on the limo ride over, so let me introduce myself. I'm Cave Johnson.
Huh.
I own the place.
Did you notice how it auto fixed that?
You might have, and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you. Fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts.
Cave Johnson, what a madman. Oh. That almost didn't work. Thank you. science.
They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Amateur, we do all our science from scratch. No hand-holding.
Cool.
Something the lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his leg. Right. Uninformative. Or so I'm told. Just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day.
For this next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors.
That sucks.
You sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants. We took care of that, too.
Just realized this is faster.
You got covered in that repulsion gel. Here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton.
I'll remember that for next time. It's faster to just...
All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is, the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds. I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me.
Rats are expensive. Oh, come on. That's definitely one of those garbage moments I've ever had.
Fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal
activity.
In
this game. That was so stupid.
The calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction.
That was so garbage.
If you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard in your skull. Most likely you forgot it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast. I'm telling them, keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time, entirely, forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Last time I actually put the wrong foot over. Great.
If you're hearing this, it means you're taking a long time on the catwalk for between tests. The lab boys say that might be a fear weird. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like rejection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grit.
So I actually went over here with that for the sole purpose. Greatest hero in the history of Newton.
Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Amateur Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff in a while. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Amateur Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you've most likely used one of the many products we invented. But
say, you're good at murder. Oh, thanks.
Yo, we're only 3 minutes behind our previous time without leads. There's definitely been more than 3 minutes of leads thus far.
The quicker you'll get your $60. Carolyn, are the compensation vouchers ready?
Yes, sir,
Mr. Johnson. Boy, did I just... Who is that? What the hell is going on here? Thank you.
Oh shit. Nice. Please.
Great job, astronaut, war hero, and or Olympian. With your help, we're gonna
take the world.
Is this on? Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
I swear I know him.
You save like 10 seconds on that. Time for my best trainer.
If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let them know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your bindle if you let us take you apart, put some science stuff in you, then put you back together. Good as new.
Oh no! What? Why? Ugh.
In case you're interested, there's still
well, that some was
available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again, all you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So, that's a complete reassembly. New vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying us. you. I can't believe I'm thanking these people. For staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing, you've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you have any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want old newspapers and sticks fluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall.
Yo, the momentum conservation, that's crazy.
Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically.
Yeah.
Employee retention, however, has not.
I do a two frame perfect jumps in a row. And then
still
I get stuck on a wall.
The beam counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mixed them into a gel. Guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deathly ill. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're going to see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Let's all stay positive. Do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills.
Yep, go back in. Why did I lose all my momentum? That was so dumb.
I've been thinking. When life gives you lemons, don't make lemonade. Make life take the lemons back. Get mad. I don't want your damn lemons. What am I supposed to do with these? Demand to see life's manager. Make life rule the day. Store a man's intelligence and personality on one. So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping, artificial intelligence. We should have been working on it 30 years ago. And I will say this, and I'm going to say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can form me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now she'll argue. She'll say she
that wasn't great. That was admittedly not great. I normally have that gun.
Surrounding.
let's get mad. If we're going to explode, let's at least explode with some dignity.
That's an all-time great quote right there. Going to explode. Shadows there. You save 20 seconds on that chapter 7.
For God's sake, your boxes with legs! It's literally your only purpose. Walking onto bugs. How can you not do the one thing you're designed for?
Try to get us down there. I'll hit it with a paradox.
Warmer. Boiling hot. Boy, okay, colder, ice cold, you're Arctic, man. You're very cold. Very, very, very cold. Look, just get on the button! Oh, that's funny, is it? Oh, it's funny, because we've been at this for 12 hours, and you haven't solved it either, so I don't know why you're laughing. You've got 1 hour! Solve it!
True. I'll go true. Yeah, that was easy. I'll be honest, I might have read that one before then. Sorry, cheating.
It's a paradox. There is no answer. Look, this place is going to blow up if I don't get back, and I'm not
False. I'll go false.
Explosion imminent. Evacuate the facility immediately.
Before I fix that.
Warning. Reactor core is at critical.
Fixed. Hey, it is great seeing you guys again. Seriously, it turns out I'm a little bit short on test subjects right now, so this works out perfect. And off we go. You have no idea what it's like in this body. I have to test all the time, or I get this itch, you know? It must be hardwired into the system or something. Oh, but I tell you, when I do test, man alive, nothing feels better. It's just, I've got to test. So, you're going to test, and I'm going to watch. Everything is going to be just fine.
Warning. Core overheating. Nuclear meltdown imminent.
I think we're in trouble.
Design this test myself. It's a little bit difficult. Yes. Oh, well done. Oh, that felt really good. Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test, pretty much. And I can just watch you solve it. Yeah, that sounds like easy. Here we go.
There, doing it.
And nothing. No, I can't blame you for trying. Okay, new tests. Gotta be some tests around here somewhere. Oh, here we go.
Alright. 10 chambers. 10 chambers. Here we go.
It shouldn't be hard to stay alive long enough to find him.
It's alright. Everything's good. I just invented some more tests.
This is one of my tests.
Not entirely. Look at the word test there on the wall. That's brand new. Test myself out of smaller tests that I found, by the way. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all wrapped in dynamite. Alright, okay, this is taking too long, okay? I'll just tell you how to solve the test, okay? See that button over there? Alright?
That's why I can't help you solve the tests.
Never mind, solve it yourself. You're on your own. Oh, yes. Well done.
Thanks. All we had to do was pull that lever.
What? What the?
I know we're in a lot of trouble and probably about to die, but that was worth it.
Glad you got that one, Travis.
Don't start yet. You are not going to believe this. I found a sealed off wing. Hundreds of perfectly good test chambers just sitting there, filled with skeletons, shut their mouth, good as new.
Skeletons,
right, I guess I don't stockpile some tests. And there we go. Be honest, you can't even tell, can you? seamless.
Oh, you're kidding me. I actually have no idea how to solve that dust chamber, because I've always just thrown the cube into the beam. I've never done it any other way.
So that last test was seriously disappointing. Apparently, being civil isn't motivating you, so let's try her way, all right? Fatty, adopted Fatty, Fatty, no parents. What? What's wrong with being adopted? Lack of parents. And also, nothing. But some of my best friends actually are orphans. But I am not a moron! Just do the test. Just do the test.
Almost.
I'm such a moron, why can't you solve a simple test?
I might have pushed that moron thing a little too far this time.
Let's go, let's pick up the pace.
Just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me, and of course, maybe proximity to the test solving might give us stronger results. What was that? Oh, sorry, I could have sworn you said something.
Are you kidding me? It's okay.
Yeah. sure you're solving these correctly. Yes, you solved it, but I'm wondering if maybe there's a number of ways to solve them, and you're picking all the worst ways. No, no, that was a fusion. Ah, what am I missing?
Well, that was marginally better than dying twice.
I'm going to take you solving these and then watch 10 at once. Get a more sort of concentrated burst of science. Oh, on a related note, I am going to need you to solve these 10 times as fast. Anyway, just give me a wave, would you, before you solve this one, alright? I don't want to spoil the ending for when I watch it later.
Really? All these tiny little pieces.
You just solved it, didn't you? I told you to tell me. Ah, why are you making this so hard for me?
Remember when I told you that he was specifically designed to make bad decisions? Because I think he's decided not to maintain any of the crucial functions required to keep this facility from exploding.
We got 3 chambers left.
This place is self-destructing, you idiot.
Was self-destructing, already fixed. Programmed in one last tremor from cleansing. One or two more tremors in there, just for fun.
Warning, core overheating.
I know Kimmy's job, I'm not a monster. Ignore what he's saying, but just keep on testing. Still nothing, let's keep moving. Sorry about the lift, it's out of service, because it melted. Might as well, give you the tour. To your left, you'll see some lights of some kind. Don't know what they do, but very exciting. And to your right, something huge. Apparently it's a walk. Oh god, Rob, that's not supposed to be there! Are you alright back there? Here, I'll turn the beam off. Wait, oh no, that's not helpful, that... I don't know why I thought that would help.
Facility.
after we take over again? Is it alright if I kill him?
Cup! You're alive! Great! Yeah, just getting a test ready for you, obviously. Who else would I be doing it for? No one. So, let's see here. Exit, exit, exit. There is no exit. No problem, I'll make an exit for your test. You two are going to love this big surprise. In fact, you might say you're going to love it to death. You'll love it until it kills you, do you think? All right, I don't know whether you're picking up on what I'm saying there.
Yes, thanks, we get it.
You solved it? Good. Good one. Good for you.
So, he's inexplicably happy all of a sudden, even though he should be going out of his mind with test withdrawal. And he's got a surprise for us. What did he find back there?
Feels bad, man. This run is, like, not significantly better than previous runs.
I'll bet you're both dying to know what your big surprise is. Well, only two more chambers.
We're running out of time. I think I can break us out of here in the next chamber. Just play along.
Surprise! We're doing it now.
Okay, credit where it's due. For a little idiot built specifically to come up with stupid and workable plans, that was a pretty well-laid trap.
You've probably figured it out by now, but I don't need to anymore. I found two little robots back here, built specifically for testing.
Oh no. He found a cooperative testing initiative. It's something I came up with to phase out human testing just before he was
Shot. That was ridiculous.
Had a bit of a brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together, and I thought to myself, yes! No, don't do that. Stand right here. Stand. Put you down. Come back. No, seriously, do come back. Please, come back, please. Okay, look, I've decided I'm not going to kill you, okay, if you come back. Oh, just thinking back to the old times, the old days when we were friends, good old friends, not enemies, and I would say something like, come back, and you'd be like, yeah, no problem. Back. What happened to those days? Can't help but notice that you're not coming back, which is disappointing. Oh, I've got an idea. Yes, in your face, I got...
Are there only four total sections?
Versus Moriarty. Aristotle versus Mashy Spike Plate. Stay still, please. Alright, stop moving. Almost going there. Almost going there. Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Come back, come back.
and called a bomb. Yo, I got it.
Hey, you pretty lady. Name's Rick. You out having yourself a little...
Warning. Core corruption at 75%. Reactor explosion timer destroyed. Reactor explosion uncertainty emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these cores...
Fuck!
Are you ready to start?
What do you think?
Interpreting vague answer as... as yes.
No. Pick up on my sarcasm.
Stalemate detected. Fire detected in the stalemate resolution annex. Extinguishing.
Cleans right off, does it? Well, that would have been good to know a little earlier.
Stalemate resolution associate. Please press the stalemate resolution button.
Don't press the button. Do not press that button.
We're so close. Don't press the button.
No! Part 5! Booby trap the stalemate button. What? Are you still alive? You are joking. You have got to be kidding me. Well, I'm still in control, and I have no idea how to fix this place.
Improved by like 3 minutes and 20 seconds. It should be sub 2 hours. Uh-oh.
Let go! We're in space!
Space!
Let go! I'm still connected! I can pull myself in! I can still fix this!
I already fixed it, and you are not coming back.
Well, no. Change your plans! Hold on to me! Titan!
Alright, enjoy the ending.
Carolyn taught me a valuable lesson. I thought you were my greatest enemy, when all along you were my best friend. The surge of emotion that shot through me when I saved your life taught me an even more valuable lesson. Where Carolyn lives in my brain.
Carolyn, delete.
Goodbye, Carolyn. You know, deleting Carolyn just now taught me a valuable lesson. The best solution to a problem is usually the easiest one. And I'll be honest, killing you is hard. You know what my days used to be like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds. I had a pretty good life. And then you showed up. You dangerous, meek, lunatic. So you know what? You win. Just go. It's been fun. Don't come back.
Sloppy things. There was some sloppy moments. I gotta get an S so that I can actually learn my text. Right, I learned things. Honestly, though, with money helping, there's probably like tons of other I just don't know that. I looked and saw Gabe Newell's name.
Goodbye, my only friend. Oh, did you think I meant you? That would be funny if it weren't so sad. Well, you have been replaced. I don't need anyone now. When I do need you, maybe I'll start feeling so bad. Don't make some new.
That's what I'm counting on.
You're someone else that's broken down. Now you only want to go on. Now I only want to go on. Now I only want to go on.
I wish I could take it all back. I honestly do wish I could take it all back. And not just because I'm stranded in space.
I'm in space.
I know who you are, mate. Yeah, we're both in space. Anyway, you know, if I was ever to see her again, do you know what I'd say?
I'm in space.
I'd say, I'm sorry. Sincerely. I am sorry I was bossy and monstrous. And I am genuinely sorry.
I'm in space.
The end.
What a run. What a run. In before wasn't recording. Yeah, that would actually be really funny if that wasn't recording. Okay, thank God.